called designers. We are designing our lives all the time, but maybe we're not doing it so thoughtfully or with so much observation or mindfulness. And permaculture gives you tools to be more thoughtful and be more successful. Gives you a lot of choices. That's what I really like about it. It would be so nice if more and more people really understood what permaculture can do for their lives, to just have a holistic way of living that's in harmony with nature, where people are caring for each other. You know, everybody wants that on some level. Permaculture is whole systems design. It's the design of the entire system and the relationships of everything in the system. And that's something that we don't do in society enough of. We have kind of a silo society where the energy is over here and food is over here and they're not mixed. But in permaculture, we integrate all of those systems and the result is a higher yield. And it's a more resilient yield, it's a more regenerative yield, it's a more sustainable yield. The first experience that I really had with permaculture was at a site in California called Quail Springs. It was a completely off-grid place. It was in a canyon east of Santa Barbara that was very degraded. It had been strip mined, it had been clear cut. There was springs running all through those canyons that had dried up because of the clear cut. This man, whose name is Warren Brush, was bringing it back. He brought back the spring, he brought back the trees, and the community that he was in was really exceptional. People respected each other, they helped each other. One of the first meals I had there was three people cooking. It was a community meal, and they were quoting Shakespeare with each other and joking, and it was so much fun. And then three different people cleaned up. Just seeing that level of cooperation and the joy that was being experienced with some of the hard work that they were doing, all of it was joyful. And that really touched me. I was like, why not? Why shouldn't we live like this? It inspired my imagination on so many levels because they were really practicing holistic design and holistic living in a way that I had never experienced or seen before. And ever since I experienced that, I wanted to do it. So I have in different places. This is maybe the fourth site that I've been to. Our permaculture farm, it's an experimental site. We're really trying to do everything permaculture here and create a place where people can come and see it in action. I love working with kids. Kids are the future. They have imagination. A lot of times they just get the concept of whole systems. They experience it viscerally. I love the Girl Scout programs and these different programs that connect kids with life. This is our food forest, and it doesn't look like food, right? But there's tons of food in here. So one thing we do is we have layers in a food forest. And we have a tree layer, which would be like this mulberry over here, over there. And we have a bush layer. This is a Simpson stopper. And there's some fruit on this. One thing we love in permaculture is to try to find things that have multiple functions. You know, so bush, this has...
It's a food.
It's a beautiful. It's wildlife food. It's, yeah.
Wow.
It's got so many uses. As a divorced woman who was a single mom when I got divorced, it was so great to have that extra independence, to have a choice, to be able to create a resilient system on my own. And I've worked in high poverty areas where that means even more for women, where they really have a choice and they can feed their kids and really put some stability into the culture in that way.
Permaculture help the air?
That's a really good question. When you work with permanent agriculture, which is what permaculture means. When you put trees in a system instead of like corn or things that die every year, then it helps pull carbon from the air and other kinds of pollution where, you know, and pollution is when you have too much of something and the system can't handle it. That's the definition of pollution. So it helps pull that out of the air and keep it in the ground. That's one way that it helps. And then trees also give oxygen to the system. And do you know, you guys notice the temperature here? It's cooler, right? Yeah, and trees actually create air conditioning. And they do that by interacting with the air. And what they're doing right now in the middle of the day when it's hot is they send up a lot of water into the air. The sun helps them to release water, and it's called evapotranspiration. And that's helping cool this area even more than the porch is cool.
There's lots of butterflies. I love it. We learn about new plants that I did not know you can eat. Beauty berries, the berries from the other trees, those were amazing. And then swimming is a lot of fun. It's definitely a magical experience to come here.
They were great to work with. I love seeing their excitement, picking the mulberries off the mulberry tree. Of course, adults are like that too. Sometimes even more so.
Well, I brought my Girl Scout troop out here today because I think sustainability is a really important subject. The way we're currently running on Earth is not sustainable, but it is difficult to know what to do about that. So I think Koreen has a great program here. She is such a fun person. She's so real. And the thing I really like about her is that she's a mom and she's worked with scouts before. She's worked with her own kids. And so she really knows how to communicate with kids and with people who are very new to this subject. And she's really, really patient. I think what I would like the Girl Scouts to get out of this type of a trip is ideas about what they can do moving forward and how we could actually change conditions on this planet. Because I think it really starts with us at home. We have to really start with environmentally friendly practices in the home and do everything that we can personally and then educate people around us. But it really does start with us.
It's hard work, but it's also joyful. And, you know, being in nature, if we were out in a straight row, you know, cornfield, weeding, and worrying about the crop failing, that is very different than how we're living here. Even if we have failures here and there, there's something that's going to survive. And the more that we build the system, the less work we have to do in the long run. So couple more years, we're going to have a food just pouring out of the system without a lot of work. The thing about permaculture is that it's more than the sum of its parts. And there is that magical thing when you start making connections, beneficial connections, then the system kind of pops. Like magic happens. People get excited because all of us at our core, we want that connection with nature and with each other. And we, and this culture often discourages that. So when you feel that and you feel like it could really happen, then again, you get back to the joy.